One of the most important skills to have as an irrigation system installer is the ability to read and understand plans so that the system is installed properly to scale and as intended by the irrigation system designer.
Many professionally installed irrigation systems, particularly residential systems, are installed using in-house design schematics or sketches. There are also areas that require submitting a plan that is drawn to scale to obtain a permit. This video will focus on the features of a professionally designed plan. Typical legends in the industry include the following. A circle indicates a sprinkler. A circle with a cross indicates a valve. A dotted line typically represents the main line, and a solid line represents the lateral lines. An important part of plan reading that should never be overlooked is the proper identification of scale and plan size. The scale should be noted somewhere on the set of plans that you are working with. Near the scale should be a directional arrow showing the direction of true north. If you have a half-size set of plans, it is important to remember that the scale will be double because the dimensions will have been cut in half. Every set of plans is drawn as a scaled-down version of the construction site. It is at the discretion of the landscape architect or irrigation designer to choose the scale at which the plans will be drawn. Plans are drawn using architectural scale or engineering scale. Most smaller site plans are drawn using architectural scale. Architectural scale in imperial units is based on the inch. So if you see 1/8 inch equals 1 foot on a scale plan drawing, that will mean for every 1/8 of an inch that you measure on the plan, it will be equal to 1 foot on the drawing and at the job site. 1 inch, or 8/8, would be equal to 8 feet on the drawing and on the job site. Other common architectural scales are 1/16 inch equals a foot, or 1/4 inch equals a foot. Imperial engineering scales are also based on the inch, but the inch is divided into equal segments depending on the scale. The 10 scale, for example, has 10 equal markings for each inch. If the scale of the drawing is 1 inch equals 10 feet, that will mean for every 1 inch you measure on the plan, it will be equal to 10 feet on the drawing and the job site. Each of the 10 marks in 1 inch on the scale is equal to 1 foot. There are other ratios found on engineering scales, and you may see these depending on the size of the site. If you see a scale of 1 inch equals 20 feet, you would use a 20 scale. Each inch would be equal to 20 feet, and each of the 20 smaller marks in an inch would be equal to 1 foot. If dealing with a metric plan set, you will see a ratio like 1 to 50, 1 to 100, or 1 to 200. For each one unit that is measured on the drawing, the real world size of it is that many times larger. So with a scale of 1 to 50, each centimeter measured on the plan is equal to 50 centimeters or 1/2 meter on the drawing and the job site. This can seem confusing at first, but with a little practice using scales and plan drawings, it will begin to make sense. The irrigation legend on a set of plans is a tool for the designer to communicate the products that are going to be used on the project. For the installer, it is a list of items that need to be procured to install the project. The legend will show and describe what each symbol or line style on the plans represents. Each symbol should state the manufacturer, model, details about the product, installation comments, and reference to a detail in the plan set giving visual representation of a proper installation. A different symbol or line type will be used for every product or pipe being installed on the site. Pay close attention to this, as some symbols will look similar but have very different watering characteristics. Piping line types may also look similar, so it's important to look at the shade of the pipe. For instance, look to see if the solid line is black or a halftone gray. A gray solid line might indicate an existing lateral line, while a solid black line might be lateral lines that need to be installed. Let's take a look at this example of a plan legend. Notice the abundance of information provided for each item. Also notice the information in the valve callouts. Each valve has a unique number that coincides with the zone terminals in the controller. It also calls out the specified valve size for that zone and the gallons per minute that should be expected from all the combined sprinklers or drip emitters. The valve size is important because you'll want to know this information when you begin your takeoffs and begin to build out your parts order. One of the most important things to identify on a set of plans before beginning any installation are sleeve locations. Sleeves should be installed before the hardscape is installed. And it will be important to verify that they were installed or will be installed prior to construction of permanent structures, especially road crossings. Breaking out and digging up roads can kill your entire profitability on a job if it is overlooked initially. When reading a set of plans, a picture says 1,000 words. Plan packages will almost always have a detail page. Details are representative drawings that depict the exact way the designers intended for that product to be installed. A detail will normally call out all fittings, pipe sizes, and necessary processes for a proper installation. Be sure to review and understand each detail and follow them carefully during installation. If any questions or discrepancies arise, contact the designer to clarify. A quick call can clear up an issue and save time and money. If there are any Hunter products on a project that don't have installation details included, you can find them on the Hunter Industries website. Just search the product page of a particular product and click the Documents tab. One more very important thing to look at when you first get a set of plans are the specifications. Along with any set of plans comes a set of specifications that explains in writing what the plans are showing. It is important to read specifications very carefully, as it may spell out many of the little details that are now shown graphically on the plan set. Specifications spell out the contractual obligations as well as dictate exact installation procedures, product types, and brand names. As the installing contractor, you will be held to following the specification whether you read them or not, so read carefully. Many plans for smaller projects will have plan notes instead of a full set of specifications. These notes will describe how the designer intends the system to be installed. Pay attention to these notes and ask questions early before installation begins. Sometimes the designer or property owner may ask for submittals during the planning process. A submittal sheet shows a picture of the product to be used, along with a list of major features and benefits. Submittal sheets are provided by the installing contractor and approved by the designer or project owner, verifying that the products specified in the design are those that were purchased and installed. A good option for gathering and saving product information is using the My List tool on the Hunter Industries website. Throughout the installation process, the foreman or someone designated by the foreman should be keeping a very detailed record of the way the system was installed. These are known as red lines or as-builts and will commonly be required upon final inspection. As-builts note the exact location of mainline components, mainline pipes, ball valves, control valves, quick couplers, sleeve locations, and other devices that may be associated with the pressurized side of the system. More often than not, things need to be adjusted ever so slightly from the plans, and record needs to be kept of these changes and their adjusted locations. Start early and often. It's very difficult to go back after the project is complete and try to recall the locations of everything that was installed. Making sure you have a good understanding of the plans of a project is the foundation for all the work you and other professionals will do while working on a project or job site. Make sure you have a firm grasp of understanding scale on a set of plans and how that translates into the site on your walkthrough. Confirm that the legend symbols are as expected and that you reference them during your project. The details and the specifications contained with a set of plans should have all of the items of the project listed so that there is no doubt as to what or how the project should be worked on. And finally, be prepared to keep track of the work that is actually done, as situations and circumstances sometimes change with the plan intended, so make sure you note exactly where and what those changes are on your as-builts.